With the current urbanization trend, already over half of the current global human population lives in cities. Especially in highly developed countries like the Netherlands, intense urbanization is taking place, exacerbating conflicts between nature and man. For this reason, road verges have become increasingly acknowledged for their important ecological function in the Netherlands, since 2% of the Netherlands is comprised out of this semi-natural network, and they preserve biodiversity by enhancing ecological interactions between nature reserves. These road verges possess a high variety of insect species, among which the carabid beetles are very abundant. Carabids, or ground beetles, are a large family with more than 40,000 species worldwide, 400 of which are found in the Netherlands. Though they vary greatly in size, they are remarkably uniform in appearance, with long legs and powerful jaws. Some species are able to fly, but rarely do so. Most carabids are ferocious predators, consuming close to their own body mass of food daily, and consume a wide range of food types. Carabid beetle diversity is assumed to be a good indicator for biodiversity. Also, they can be seen as pollution indicators, since heavy metals, pesticides and fertilizers negatively affect their abundance. Carabid beetle abundance and diversity has a value in itself as well. Since a high number of ground beetles are carnivorous, they can lower the chance of pest development, and they function as prey species for a lot of different bird and animal species. In this research, we strive to find the effect of different vegetation structures on the abundance and diversity of carabid beetle species in road verges. The outcome of this research could be used to improve management of road verges in order to enhance their ecological value. Our research question was, how do different vegetation structures, that is, litter cover, vegetation cover, height, density, and heterogeneity of road verges affect carabid beetle abundance and diversity? We expected to find an increase in carabid beetle abundance and diversity with increased level of litter cover, shade by vegetation, vegetation height, vegetation density, and heterogeneity, as we expected this to provide an increased number of niches for prey and shelter from predators. Not all relations were expected to be linear, resulting in an optimum curve for some of these relationships, as is often the case in ecology. In order to answer our research questions and test our hypotheses and predictions, we designed a study with a field and a lab element. In the field, a correlative study was done by catching beetles in road verges and measuring the predefined vegetation structures and surrounding characteristics. In the lab, a manipulative study was constructed, aimed to find beetle preferences for specific levels of vegetation structures. Here, our correlative field study will be explained. To determine the sample size of our field study, we looked at literature. In a research by Bros in 2002, the authors sampled 11 road verges to show the difference between two road verge management styles. Because we looked not at one, but at 5 different variables within the road verges, we decided that 55 samples would surely be enough to find statistical differences. A post hoc power analysis of the results of our 55 samples showed a power of 1.0 for both species and abundance of beetles found. The correlative field study was carried out within the city of Wageningen. A total of 55 strategic stratified samples with pitfall traps were allocated to road verges throughout the city. According to several authors, litter cover is considered to exert the most influence on carabid numbers and diversity. For this reason, it is considered the main independent factor for selecting samples. Hence, sample locations were selected to contain a complete range of litter cover in a gradient from 0 to 100%. Each sample consisted out of 5 pitfall traps made from empty plastic cups that were dug in the ground. Here you can see a schematic representation of the pitfall setup. The 5 cups were placed in a cross pattern 1 meter apart. Around each sample, we measured covariables that we expected may influence carabid numbers. due to the beetle's relatively small action radius of 3 meters a day, heterogeneity, litter cover and tree cover was determined within 3 meters of the central pitfall. Vegetation density and height were determined in 4 10 by 10 centimeter plots, located 50 centimeters from the corner pitfalls, due to the time intensity of these measurements.
The values obtained from these measurements were assumed to be representative for the whole plot. Random variables were also measured, as they were expected to influence the measured independent variables. These include width of the road verge in meters, road verge isolation. This resulted in a five-factor design.
We measured vegetation heterogeneity by counting the total number of different plant species. Litter cover was noted as the estimated amount of ground covered by dead leaves. This estimation was made by two observers independently, and then averaged to reduce observer bias. Furthermore, we measured vegetation cover using a solar radiation system, which measures the sun's radiation in PAR, a photoactive radiation, above and below the vegetation. By subtracting the PAR below the vegetation from the PAR above the vegetation, the total radiation extinguishment was calculated, which is a good measure for the amount of vegetation cover. Vegetation height was measured using a drop disc, which is a tube with vertical measuring scale, and a very lightweight disc that rests atop the vegetation. Vegetation density was measured by counting plant stalks within a 10 by 10 centimeter plastic cutout at the four locations. We will now follow the life of Bert the Carabid Beetle and his extraordinary journey through our field study. Here, we will present the most significant results of our field study. Over 1100 beetles of 39 different species were caught in the field. 17 of these species were carabid beetles. We caught almost 400 individuals of the species Nibria brevicolis. This species is known to be the most widely distributed and most frequently caught beetle in Europe. The results of our field work are tested using a generalized linear regression with a Poisson link. With the regression, we tend to find the environmental values which best explain the beetle species occurrence. A Poisson distribution was needed because the data consists out of counts of the numbers of beetles per species. We took the 6th most abundant carabid species and analyzed them separately. The reason for this is that the spread in species occurrence within the different environmental gradients is too high to be able to analyze them together. As you can see in this graph, for 4 of these species, litter is a significant factor affecting their presence, but they all respond very differently. Nebria brevicolis and Loricera pilcornis have the highest occurrence in high litter cover, whilst both the Amara species are mostly found in low litter cover. For another 4 species, the presence or absence of tree cover is a significant factor affecting their occurrence, as you can see in this graph. Also for this factor, we found that species responded differently. The 2 most left species are more abundant in verges with tree cover, and the 2 most right species are more abundant with no trees present. To supplement the results of our regressions, we used the PCA to clarify the explaining variables of our 9 most commonly found carabid species. The PCA graph shows the first 2 axes. The first one with eigenvalue of 0.373 is correlated with the amount of litter. The second axis, with an eigenvalue of 0.209, is correlated with tree cover. 6 of the 9 tested species are positively correlated to litter, which validates our prediction. Nebria brevicolis is strongest associated to litter cover. 3 species are negatively correlated to litter. When looking at the ecology of these species, aversion can be explained as they are associated to grassy vegetation. Predation may be an explanation for the negative association with tree cover for most of the species. Trees located right above the beetle's habitat may be used by birds as a vantage point to hunt from, causing the beetles to avoid trees. Here, our lab experiment will be explained, in which we aimed to test which types of vegetation structures are preferred by beetles and in which amounts. Our research question was: which condition of the different vegetation structures is preferred by carabid beetles, and which of these structures is preferred in general? We predict to find more beetles with an increased level of the specific isolated vegetation structures. To test this, we designed and built a 4-factorial lab experiment. We built 5 styrofoam arenas, 4 to test the 4 different independent variables, density, height, litter cover and shade, and a 5th to test which between these 4 was the most preferred variable. The 4 variables were tested in 5 levels from low to high amounts. Height and density were simulated by using wooden sticks, dried leaves for litter, and elevated anti-rooting membrane for vegetation cover. By not using real vegetation, we decreased the possibility of confounding factors. For litter, we decided to use clean, dried leaves to make sure there were no confounding factors caused by moisture or food availability in the leaves. Each afternoon, 15 beetles were introduced in each arena, equally divided over the 5 levels, which means 3 individuals per level. They were left in the dark for the night, and the next morning the location of each beetle was registered, and the beetles were removed. Unfortunately, some beetles managed to escape the arena, resulting in some missing values. As stated before, in the experiment we used Nebria brevicolis, a common carabid species and the species we collected the most in our traps. We decided to use only 1 species of beetle. Because of their predatory nature, different carabid species in the same arena may interact as predator and prey, introducing a 3rd variable, predation, affecting beetle preference. After each experiment, the 5 levels were randomly rearranged for location within the arena, and new beetles were introduced each day and left overnight. In the experiment, we used a total of 70 beetles in each of the arenas, which were sampled over the course of 5 sampling days. The results of these sampling days were summed and analyzed with a number of chi-square tests. Here, we will present the most significant results of our lab experiment. To analyze the results of the experiment, we first look at the four isolated variables: vegetation density, height, cover, and amount of leaf litter. We first tested if the beetles actually preferred the vegetation that was created over the corners on the edge of the box. As we told you earlier, the four arenas that we constructed in the experiment contain an outer ring without structure. We noted that if beetles were found in the corners, that they were out of the experiment. If more beetles were found in the corner than in the vegetation, we assumed that this vegetation type is not preferred at all, and thus cannot be important for beetles. As you can see in this graph, the litter and density tests show very small amounts of beetles in the corners of the arenas. We see this as a high preference for the simulated vegetation type. Cover also shows a significantly higher number of beetles in the vegetation, but also a considerable number of corner beetles. Vegetation cover may thus not be a very strong variable determining beetle choice. Take a look at the next graph. Here we see the results of our findings within the isolated density plot. You can clearly see most beetles by far are found in the part with the highest density, significantly higher than the expected values. All the other parts had a significantly lower amount of beetles. We can conclude that beetles have a high preference for vegetation with a high density. This might be explained by beetles seeking the need for sufficient shelter from predators. Denser vegetation not only makes the beetles less visible, but also harder to reach, as we have found out firsthand during our experiments. The litter test shows a very similar result as we saw in the density test. Significantly higher amounts were found in the highest litter density, and the amount found in the lower density is much lower than logically expected. These results are quite extraordinary. One leaf should provide sufficient cover for a 15mm beetle, so for shelter, the lower amounts of litter should provide equal protection. We therefore believe that these results can be explained by expected food availability, because this beetle species preys on other small invertebrate, like worms, springtails and snails. We believe that the beetle actively seeks out the vegetation that is expected to contain the most food. Finally, in the last experiment, the four factors are combined to show the most preferred variable in beetle choice. This graph shows the number of beetles in each of the different variables. You can clearly see that a significant amount of beetles were found in litter cover. The other three variables are chosen far less and are significantly lower than the chi-square expected values. We can therefore conclude that our prediction for the importance of litter cover is validated. The shelter, and most importantly food that this habitat structure normally provides, makes the beetles actively seek it out, and may thus be an important variable for increasing beetle diversity. After this research, we can conclude that litter is indeed a strong predictor for beetles, since the regression and PVA analysis both show a strong association with the amount of litter. This finding is validated for Nebria brevicolis in the lab, which shows a high preference for this type of vegetation. But the answer is not that simple. Some species are negatively correlated to litter, and for some, litter does not seem an important factor. Other factors like density of vegetation or heterogeneity may be more important for these species. It is clear that road verges can thus not be managed uniformly to accommodate all beetle species. Although trees providing litter are important, networks of different types of verges with different types of vegetation and structure are needed to maintain beetle diversity.